from Overpal as well as Jankos roaming to the middle lane, and it didn't work out. Gonna need a stronger start this time around.
Yeah, and that game again, he was against the Kassadin. The matchup we keep talking about, how he's not really in favor of LeBlanc in the laning phase here, definitely after level 6. And that's again why Rocket bans the Kassadin so they can take LeBlanc, have an assassin who can actually one-on-one Febivan in the laning phase here, try and really challenge him, because the games he played last week, Febivan had no problems with sitting back and farming, and now Fnatic can again lock in this Sivir-Rengar combo, which is so good. There's going to be any reply from Steelback and Yellowside, then they need him. And then you miss your cocoon.
Oh, the death sentence connects though. Vander's
okay,
got in.
Fan
first blood to the first blood king. Jankos does it again. And Vander with a great death sentence to open up the game.
Now he have the assist instead, giving him enough gold to go back and get it. Now Reignover. Again, pre-level 60 on the ring. I want to go for overpower.
That's the flash route from Huni. And an easy 2-on-1. That'll make up for the small mistake from Huni earlier in the game. Here comes Reignover. He's looking for the baller strike. We do see Lissandra coming. Insta-flash from Overpower. Solar Flare connects. He's level 7. Gonna get locked up in the tomb. And it's gonna be Yellowstar that gets the kill credits.
They do sacrifice the top lane for it here. Would probably have lost the tower anyway. So Fnatic just trying to get a kill out of it. Steelback though, he needs to be careful.
On the inner turret, they just don't have the minions to work with. Huni, he's gone in, he's rooted them in place. Glacial Tomb, but a three-man Gnarled throws Fnatic against the wall. Rocket, they're gonna survive and get the first kill of the fight as Jankos was able to rappel away. Fnatic with an uncharacteristically bad dive is gonna lose that one clearly. 1-3, maybe disrespecting the Gnar.
Oh, completely disrespecting him. Keeping all five guys around this red buff here.
Gnar counter's very, very low. It's not charged.
Look at Huni and his position. He's going in.
Woolite coming in. He's caught. Woolite, the solar flare's caught him as well. Woolite is down. Where is Nuke Duck? What can he do? Jankos forced to flash away. The Pew comes out from Febivan, but it doesn't result in a kill. Jankos gets out clean, but Nuke Duck is down, and Fnatic with two quick kills, they're peeling for Baron.
So talking about Fnatic here, waiting for the right play. Didn't really want to go too over-aggressive, and then they see red buff spawning. They move in here, place a few wards around. Didn't even actually see where Rocket was coming from, but because Huni had such a great position around the Crooks here, there was no wards on him. He could get onto Woolite, the carry in the backline, and kill him. Overpower, time to be a man.
There is a Mega Gnar that's been stunned up, 2,500 K. He gnaws Fnatic against the wall. Huni gets healed. He wants a Huni pot. Overpower is not overpowered, and he goes down. Baron secured by Fnatic.
Unless Overpower can come around from the flank here.
There's no flash available. Reignover's been wrecked. He's been pulled back. The box is out. Huni decides to not go in. The Gnar does connect with Yellowstar against the wall. We've only lost Reignover. What more can come? Huni gets hooked. Nuke Duck jumps on him and blows him up. And just like that, Vander lands hook after hook.
Big wave pushing in top as well. So if they keep Fnatic around here, then we'll get some damage on this top two, which is already fairly low.
Oh, look at
Reignover.
This. On the thrilling hunt. That was both ultimate. Solar Flare goes wide. They have managed to shut down Overpal despite a slight guff of the ultimates across the board. But Fnatic, with the numbers advantage, again moving to Dragon. They do not want to give Rocket more dragons.
Yeah, like right now, which is why they control the support room, and there's Engage.
Well, Jankos is in trouble. Jankos repels. Can he get away? Nuke Duck is trying to find some kills as Jankos is on the back line. His repel kept him alive for a while, but now Reignover, his reign is about to be over. Still alive, nobody's gone down. Buster Shot kicks Reignover away. Overpal's come in. Meganar stuns Yellowstar against the wall, but Overpal's got no support. We see the right of the Arcane. Shots coming out. Flash, Boomerang Blade. The third one gets a double kill. Febivan, you are here. Fnatic win the fight after an extended engage and peel to Baron.
So for Bivin here, he uses two charges off the ulti and then he saves the last one. He waits for Woolite to keep moving and try and trick him. And Woolite walks into Jankos, who's trying to recall, and the last charge hit. Double kill, Baron.
As long as Fnatic remain groups.
Yeah, it's gonna be all about again Woolite getting to a 4-5 item on Tristana. Or maybe getting a hook onto Huni.
Oh, Huni's in trouble. Hourglass goes out. Glacial Tomb is still available. He's gonna throw that down on himself. Just as we talk about it, Fnatic are the ones that make the small misplay, allowing themselves to get caught by those death sentences.
You can't really afford, before you have at least a last whisper, to go for
Look at Woolite in the back line. Rainover went in, tried to set something up. Rainover's flashed over there, caught Nuketuck. Nuketuck's been caught out as Honey gets hit by the Death Sentence. Now Overpass trying to run interference. He gnaws Fnatic back before flashing into the team and getting squashed down. Rocket have lost one, Fnatic have lost two, but look at right of the Arcane. 2-3, Summoner Heal keeps Jankos alive. Over the wall, Nuketuck goes, he gets Yellow Star. Rocket, 1-3, have won the fight.
Engage onto Woolite, didn't work for Rainover here. Woolite managed to jump away, and now Rocket turn it around. First time we see them win a fight here. It's all about these two carries, Woolite and Nuketuck. Keep them alive and you have a chance.
We'll call him Barry Bond then, Sir James Bond. Baron is secured here by Rocket. Fnatic out of position.
Pushing in, which was a thing they did so well beforehand. Oh, that Baron thing actually just gave Nuketuck away. And yet he gets the kill.
Well,
he popped up the minions nuked in the bush, and yet Rainover ends up dying for it.
Not
that Soul Stealer
on Yellow Star and Rainover to lock Woolite down. There's Woolite, he's been caught out right to the Arcane. Will it connect? That's the question. Buster Shot comes out, the slow is out. Woolite's still alive. Lantern pulls him out. All three shots are right to the Arcane's not up. Jankos gets caught out by the Glacial Tomb. Finally, the teleport's coming in from Overpal. Fnatic have managed to trade 1-2. Jankos in retreat with Nuketuck's aid. Just as we were saying that Rainover's not going to be able to stick to Woolite, he does. Energy to actually face down four members of Fnatic. Got the ward down. Smite is available for both of these junglers. They've started off the Baron Deficio. This could be it. On the Hunt comes out from Steelback. Throwing Hunt available from Rainover. Death Sentence connects for Baron. That is so much damage. Baron is secured for Fnatic and Jankos gets downed in the fight. We see Yellowstar, the first victim from Fnatic, before Overpal is running racket on Fnatic. Overpal still alive in the back line. We see Nuketuck flashing away from Rainover, waiting for those cooldowns. Right of the Arcane comes
out.
That's a triple kill for Steelback. The fight is over and Fnatic have done it. They're going to push the minions in. And just like that, Renotic. Rocket are destroyed by Fnatic.
And again, Rainover in this fight here, 1-on-1 against Woolite, and he actually wins it. He has the Thorn Mail as well. He stuck to him, he forced Woolite to just only focus him, and then the rest of the team could finish it. Fnatic, after a long, long game, the first time we really see him go full late game, still managed to take the win.
Complete pressure on both of these teams. Fnatic holds true.